Big Shadow.
Why'd you bring me here? To show me the day-to-day life in some backwater village?
When I mentioned the tale of the first warrior of light, did you expect it to begin with a sign from above and journeys filled with mystery and wonder? My tale is one that actually happened, not something pulled from a storybook.
And so what?
Let's say for a moment that you are the Warrior of Light written in the prophecy. Tell me, where would your tale begin? It would not begin with an edict from on high, angels descending from the heavens to sing. No, your tale commenced the exact moment you came into existence. And like any good story, there are twists and turns along the way. But people judge protagonists by how they live their lives, not where they first came from.
But I don't know how I've lived my life. My memories are gone. Yet, I think I know what you're getting at.
That is all I can ask. The details matter little in the end, as long as the greater picture has been made clear.
Show me what's next. when you told me that you were the first Warrior of Light, I expected a hero. But, you were just a nobody.
I was a no-name country boy from a nondescript village. My talents with a blade were better than average, perhaps. But never had I left my homeland and traveled the world.
Everyone else was a nobody too. Sarah, Chaos.
We were all ordinary people, living ordinary lives. Never had I pictured myself being an adventurer. Let's just say, it wasn't exactly on my list of things to do. Interesting thing about being a protagonist. The hands of fate can be turned by others against your will. Something or someone was working against me, and the whole time I had been none the wiser.
I don't need you to spell out for me who the Warrior of Light's enemy was.
Chaos, you are mistaken. I have always pledged to be your wife. I pine after no other but you. No, misunderstand. He has no feelings for me. I did go see him, but the two of us merely talked. I swear to you.
That's chaos. He doesn't look all that tough for someone supposedly terrorizing the countryside. I expected someone worthy of the name, but I guess not.
Chaos used to be a human being, just like you or me. It was a bit later when things started to get more complicated. He was stripped of all vestiges of individuality and compassion, and became the entity you know him as today. An agent of destruction, and a wanton monster whose enmity and hatred know no bounds.
I don't think I get it. How was he stripped of individuality? Is such a thing even possible?
Perhaps I have gotten ahead of myself. It will be but a little while before all is made clear.
Thank you.
this memory?
There is but one more person whom you should know about. A trickster among tricksters. His name, his voice.
Lord Chaos, you find yourself at a crossroads with rumors about you spreading like wildfire. All the people in Palamecia's cities and villages speak of you in hushed whispers. Your soon-to-be wife, the Lady Sarah, she too dares not lift her face to look at you. Her heart belongs to another, a skilled swordsman in a small village. These are the kinds of rumors they spread about you, and you don't stand up to them. They find you a boorish, intolerant man, who imposes his will on the common folk and nobility alike. But fret not, Lord Chaos. Your humble servant has devised a plan to turn the tides. If the Lady Sarah has eyes only for the village's most prestigious swordsman, then dethroning him and claiming that title for yourself would win the lady's heart. Oh yes, a display of your power would show all detractors that you are not a joke to be spread in taverns. All you need to do is host a grand tournament to prove that Lord Chaos is not a man to be trifled with. And the victor will be you, and none other.
Does that voice not remind you of something? Someone.
It does. A voice preaching incessantly about the laws of Palamecia.
And those same laws of Palamecia came into being shortly after that conversation.
Thank you.
believe I mentioned this before, but most painful memories have a distinct beauty when viewed from a far enough distance. Most, but not all. Some remain fresh, no matter how many times they have been bandaged. Wounds best left alone.
If they're too painful to remember, then why not just forget them?
Because they are lessons for others to learn from. Lessons that can help you turn despair into hope. I made a pact to never turn my back on the abject despair that I myself once felt.
Come one, come all, and listen well to my words. I hereby announce the first Palamecian Grand Tournament. I bid all who feel up to the challenge to test their mettle. Yet be warned that in all tests of strength, injury, and perhaps death, are a persistent threat. You there, do you quiver in anticipation or in fear? Then allow me to sweeten the pot. The man who emerges the victor will win the glorious prize of having one of their most dear wishes granted on the spot. Ah, but perhaps you do not believe. Fear not. The patron of the Grand Tournament is none other than Lord Chaos, a man who wishes for your success. Yet do not think that Lord Chaos will dictate the rules of engagement to exert power over those less fortunate than he. For you, dearest citizens, have the authority to choose them yourselves. They will be called the Laws of Palamecia!
That's Vox, but he seems more normal.
He used to be a mere human as well.
And then became what he is today. remember that the Prophecy had a tournament. The Warrior of Light supposedly would win a victory by default, not in combat.
That is true. Another one of my so-called exploits that came to become part of the Prophecy. As you can see, my tale is tied inevitably to it.
Chaos is entering the competition too. Do you think he'll marry Sarah if he wins?
Maybe. He seems confident.
But there's no way he can. I mean, not if you're there, right? And you will be.
You signed me up?
I had to. Who else can win and get Chaos to open up the sluice gates? Come on. You're our best swordsman. You owe it to everyone here.
So, this was the first tournament. And you managed to eke out a victory without harming anyone, right? That makes sense.
Does it? I would ask you not to assume, but to see the truth with your own two eyes.
Why do I have to see it for myself when you're here to tell me exactly what happened?
Because what's important isn't the end result. It's what you learn on the way there. How you've grown and matured in the process, and how you interpret the two. Even though I never intended to leave my village behind and set out on a life-altering adventure, I was forced to by things beyond my control, and my fate was decided on the battlefield rather than the rice field.
So you didn't like fighting?
I resented the unfairness of reality, and complained every last step of the way. I want to show you everything that I saw, heard, and felt in my journey. If you learn why my path was the way that it was, you might find clues on how to overcome the forces that seek to shape your life, particularly when you are faced with choices that may end in anger. That is my gift to you.
So I'm supposed to learn from you and live in exactly the same way?
No. I ask that you pay close attention to what I show you. Take whatever kernels of wisdom that you may, and use them so that you do not end up a lonely old man. The Warrior of Light's long journey began in a tiny, nondescript village. A village that had long been terrorized by its ruler, Chaos. I should have spent my life there as a simple farmer. Yet the threads of fate bound me endlessly to the sword. I was forced to bear arms against the evil that threatened us. I fell prey to abject despair, and the path before me was laden with thorns. Yet from this despair I rose, bringing hope to this world as the Warrior of Light. And in so doing, I forever changed the order of this world. From this very disorder, Palamecia's insatiable desire to be regaled with tales of hope was born. For example, a tale of an ordinary young man rising up against evil, vanquishing it to restore peace to a long-suffering world. People wish not to think. They wish to be comforted. Yes, my tale can teach you much about the true nature of Palamecia, how it came to be, and why it is how it is. But some tales must be experienced, not told. And this tale will reveal the origin of the Warrior of Light.
How was my master's past? The Warrior of Light began not from glory, but obscurity.
Certainly not anything to write home about. Does it get better?
Though the days may have looked calm and peaceful, there was evil bubbling just beneath the surface. Where we stand now is much the same. You may find it to be still and quiet, but nothing could be further from the truth.
Is that so?
This place exists between reality and my master's memories. A land of countless battles, both amalgamated and warped in form. I hesitate to call it hell, but instead, a place for atonement. But more than that, it's also a place for a prospective Warrior of Light to train.
Now we're back to the endless trials.
If we are to continue down this path of memories, you must experience more personal growth and unlock your potential. But if you truly feel that you are ready for what lies ahead, then I will let you pass without any objections.
Well done! anywhere?
Thank you.
darkness, engulf them.
Yeah. light.
Echo, you've been awfully quiet recently. It's like you've been hiding on purpose.
No, I'm fine. I'm more worried about how Sid is running you ragged with his memories.
Yeah, his lectures do get a bit oppressive. He keeps going on and never gets to the point. I can see why his tale mirrors that of Palamecia. It's riddled with all types of secrets.
The original Warrior of Light, then it would make sense for him to have a profound impact on Palamecia's future.
The original, huh? His tales. They contain names that I've come across too. Sarah, Chaos, even someone sounding like Vox. Will I end up seeing you too?
No. You see, I'm not exactly the type of being who would create a world from nothing. Fairies are beings who help make existing worlds go round.
Well, I guess what's important is getting the old man to hurry it up. Who knows how many years and years it'll take if I run across you, too. But don't worry about me. You just take care along the way.
Hey, thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you. Beat this!
Just